Hi, my name's Melissa Acero. I'm a 11th grader and I'm a student in Project Rousseau.
I'm a freshman at Columbia University and I'm a mentor in Project Rousseau at Central Park East High School.
Hi, my name is Tia Marie Gaston. I'm in 11th grade and I'm a student here at Project Rousseau.
My name is William Santos and I go to LaGuardia Community College.
I'm Jareen. I'm a freshman at Central Park East and I'm a student at Project Rousseau, New York City.
My name is Alejandro Cortez. I am a junior in Central Park East High School and I am a student in Project Rousseau, New York City.
Welcome to Project Rousseau. My name is Andrew Heinrich and I'm the founder of Project Rousseau. I founded Project Rousseau in 2011 to give students the opportunities to grow into college students and adults who they want to become. We're about growth, career exploration, and building the skills and knowledge that you need to succeed in the future. Over the next few minutes, you're going to hear from some of my top students about all of the opportunities that are available to a student in Project Rousseau. That includes the mentoring program, SAT prep, trips, career exposure, and also fun nights. You will hear from students who are doing all sorts of different activities with Project Rousseau outside of our mentoring, our core of SAT prep and college readiness programming. You'll hear from kids who are in our French class, kids who are doing our exchange program with students in places like Denmark and Kenya, students who have gone on trips with us to museums, for many of whom this was their first time ever stepping foot in a museum. And you're going to hear from students of ours who, most importantly to me, engage in community service on a weekly basis with me. We hope that you find a lot of this exciting. I know it certainly is to me, and I can let the students speak for themselves about how exciting it is for them. We're really excited to have you on board, and we hope this is your first of many meetings with Project Rousseau students in other parts of the country.
To me, Project Rousseau means being able to work as a community to do all these amazing things and getting to meet people I would have never met without Project Rousseau.
It means a lot because it helped me pass my U.S. Regents. I couldn't graduate with my 2012 class in the summer, so I had to go to summer school.
Project Rousseau means to me to get to like the next level, a step ahead.
Like if I haven't been in Project Rousseau, I don't think I would be as like focused to get into college as, you know, I am now.
I don't think I could have passed the test without Project Rousseau help, because even though I went to summer school, it helped me a lot because it was like one-on-one. So I really needed the help.
Project Rousseau is going to help me get on the college-bound path and help me reach my destination.
Thanks to Project Rousseau, I know what I want to do with my life, and I know like what I want to do with colleges, what I want to do to get into college. And they've also helped me a lot with like SATs and just bettering myself as a person.
To me, it means a lot of things. It is a way to develop yourself and develop your skills and helps you decide where you want to go in college and where you want to go in your career.
Project Rousseau, I thought it was a great opportunity for me to give back to the community and help people out, especially my specific mentee, McGavock.
If I never got the help from Project Rousseau, I think I would be in high school still with some of my friends.
I think where I would be today if I was not a part of Project Rousseau, I would probably not be doing as well as I would be in my classes. In my scores would not have been well for my SAT scores, and I probably would fool around a lot more and not get work done.
People in Project Rousseau, I now know what it's like to take an SAT, what to expect, what to aim for, what my goals should be. And because of that, I'm really set on what I want to do with myself.
Project Rousseau helped me learn ways to like study and have more responsibility in myself.
It's helped me develop my skills. It's helped me develop as a person, and it's helped me improve overall in everything that I do.
I think it's just the overall like sort of bonding with all the other kids. I mean, everyone has different things to do in Project Rousseau, but it's just the fact of being able to come together as a community and being able to like, you know, just sort of chill out with each other and learn from each other.
It prepares me on what, how college is going to be like, and helps me decide which college I want to go to, what I'm interested in, what I'd like to learn, what I want to study, what I want to major in.
When I was back in high school, I took the U.S. Regents like 5 times, and I never could have passed it. I always got like a 40-something, 55, less than 60 all the time. I couldn't understand it. Like, it was hard for me to get like knowledge, understand the topics and stuff. And then when I had to take it in summer, in June, I failed the test and I had to go to summer school. I couldn't graduate with my friends, class of 2012. I had to go to summer school. I felt horrible because, you know, I've been with my friends since 2008, and then we had a grad, you know, it was a class, it was like a family. We had to graduate together, and it made me feel horrible because I was the only one that didn't graduate with them. And then Andrew, he offered help me pass the test. And then since then, we just started working together and, you know, meeting up every week.
The core of Project Rousseau is the mentoring program. As a member of Project Rousseau, you will be paired one-to-one with a college student. For McGavock students, that means a student at Vanderbilt University. Now, what's the purpose of being paired with someone on a one-to-one basis? Why can't it just be a group of students with a group of Vanderbilt students? And the answer for that is that we try and individualize our approach to meet your needs. This isn't about a cookie-cutter approach. This is about what you need and your specific desires and goals for the future. Let me tell you about my mentee. Denzel is now in his first year of college. It didn't always look like he would get there. In fact, graduation kind of came down to the wire for him. But if there's one thing that I could say about Denzel, it's that he was willing to do whatever it took. Denzel had extraordinary difficulties in his life. Bounced around different homes, and it was hard for him to find a really solid support system that was with him day in and day out. That's where Project Rousseau came in. We found a young man who was willing to do the work, but didn't have the direction that he felt he needed. We made up for that, and now Denzel, one semester into college, is starting his cycle in majoring in mechanical engineering, hoping to one day work on designing cars. At graduation, in a way that sums up everything it means to be Denzel, Denzel got the award for perseverance. And if there's one word that I am most proud of for attaching to Denzel or any of my students, it's perseverance. Denzel visits back now as a college student. And what I love about him is that he sits down certain kids, often those who he knew when he was in high school, and says, listen, it's time to get to work. And if you need help, look at what I did. Do what I did. Become a part of Project Rousseau. And if you already are, become more committed. Because if you commit to them, they'll commit to you. And that's how it works. He tells them that the biggest difference between high school and college is that in high school, the resources come to you. But in college, you need to go find the resources. And that Project Rousseau helped him bridge that gap between the expectations in high school and college. I'm so proud of him when I see him now as an adult, because I know how hard it was for him. So if you're in a place right now where you think, you know what, Project Rousseau might not even apply to me because college might not be an option. The only way that that statement is right is if you make it right. If you want to go to college, we know how to get you there. We'll get you with a mentor, we'll get you the SAT prep, we'll give you the other opportunities that you need to build a set of experiences to prepare you to succeed in college. And throughout the rest of this video, you're going to hear about some of the things we do outside of the mentoring. The mentoring program is the core of Project Rousseau. That's going to be what helps you start to build the skills and the confidence that you need to go through the other parts of the program, the SAT prep, the college process, all of the different experiences that we have, the summer internship placement. In the next few minutes, you're going to hear about the different opportunities available to a student as Project Rousseau, the SAT prep, the college process, summer internships, exchange programs with students in foreign countries, learning new languages, field trips. These are all sorts of things that we do with our students. And sometimes that can seem really intimidating. It might feel like, you know, I'm not ready for all of this. I don't know if I can handle it, even if I really want to. The great news is, that's what your mentor is for. Your mentor will guide you through all of this, will help you figure out which opportunities you want to pursue, not what we want you to do, and help you find your interests so that by the time you get to college, you know exactly where to situate yourself and how to find success and happiness in the college lifestyle.
Because of Project Rousseau, I am never lost. I always have my mentor to guide me.
We've hung out a lot, and we've done some homework. I've helped him, tutored him a little bit. Whenever he has questions, you can always call me, and we're hopefully going to be able to play some basketball with him. He's getting better, especially in his writing. That's where he used to struggle the most, and I think I've helped him, and other people in Project Rousseau have also been able to help him become stronger writing. He's become a lot more confident in his schoolwork, and a lot more confident as a person in general. He's not afraid to take any opportunities or chances, and when I first met him, he was shy, and now he opens up to me a little more and talks with me a couple times, and just sat and talked about life. And any questions in general he's had, I'll be able to hopefully help out with those.
SAT prep is a crucial component to prepare you for college. I've never liked when people call it an admissions test. I don't see SAT prep as something to help you get into college, even though it does that. I think of SAT prep as a way to prepare you to succeed once you get to college. Because the study skills you're going to learn in our SAT prep course are exactly the same ways that you should study when you get to college. This is not a conventional SAT prep class where you just do sections all day long and then try and get them right. We teach you the skills. We don't teach process of elimination until the very end. And the reason why we do that is I'd rather focus on teaching you how to find the right answer than learn how to eliminate obviously wrong answers. In fact, when we practice in class, we don't even have the answer choices in front of us because we learn the skill sets that you need for each type of question. The S in SAT stands for standardized. That means that they want to be able to figure out how prepared you are for college compared to students in New York, compared to students all around the world. So they can only ask a certain number of different types of questions. We're going to prepare you for each of those types of questions. And you're going to memorize a lot. Eventually, I'll be able to come down here in a few months and ask you, what's the first word of the second sentence of the fourth paragraph of your SAT essay? And you'll know that it's however, because you've studied that. I want to make the SAT have as few surprises for you as possible on test day, so that when you get there, it's just another day. It's just another practice SAT because you've been doing it with us for a while. Grant and I both played football in college. It's the same idea that you use in sports. You practice and practice and practice and try and make the conditions as real as possible and prepare yourself as much as possible so that when you get to the test day, it's things you've done already. Our kids have improved incredibly on the SAT, have made really inspiring progress. But what's great about our SAT prep program is that improved SAT scores correlate with improvements in other parts of their lives and in their schoolwork. If you don't know what correlation is, that's a week 7 vocabulary word in the SAT prep course. And it means to match. So, as your SAT scores improve in our SAT prep course, so do your grades. You might ask yourself why that is. It's not because of the cognitive skills, the stuff you know. It's because of what teachers call the non-cognitive skills, the things you're able to do. The ability to take notes, which we learn in our SAT prep class, is crucial to any class you take. Finding a study method that's right for you, which you learned in SAT prep, is crucial to everything else you'll do in life. So I really think of SAT prep as a vehicle. It's not a part of Project Rousseau. I really think that it's a way to take our students from where they are now to where they need to be in order to succeed in college. As a part of Project Rousseau's SAT prep program, you'll get all of these things. Everything we do is free of charge. And our goal is by the end of the class, when you're right about ready to take the SAT, we have a little bit of a party. We have two, one before and one after. My students like parties. And you write together a full SAT. Because if you can write the test, you can take the test.
It's actually really fun. I think the one thing I love about SAT prep is getting to learn all the new vocabulary words. Like, if it wasn't because of this, I wouldn't know what an orator was or, like, the difference between all the sort of terms behind compromise.
It has increased my SAT scores, well, practice SAT scores greatly, and even now I see improvement as I take full-length SATs and I get around a 50-point increase within each week, each test that I take.
It's fun and interactive, and we learn about strategies, about how to do sentence completions, and I also improved in like reading comprehension because I'm really bad at it. And I learned how to do math problems, and it not only helped me do it at CT, but also do it in the classwork because I learned how to do like some of the stuff I hadn't learned yet, so I had like a disadvantage over the kids, mm-hmm. and I kind of learned better.
It's actually really helped because I never knew what to expect from an SAT, and going in every Saturday to take an SAT actually helped. Now I think I'm more prepared for an SAT.
Well, my scores because of Project Rousseau have increased greatly, and I believe without Project Rousseau, I would probably have a huge gap in my SAT scores from where they would be without them from where they are now.
I've improved a lot. Before I used to be like a, meh student. Now it's like I know, what scores I want to get.
It shows people how well you can do. It shows people your acuity. It shows people what you can do with what you're given.
SAT prep matters a lot because it helps you get into the college you want. And based on those scores, it's sort of like those scores are your future. 75% of it.
One of the newest and most exciting parts of Project Rousseau is our exchange program with Reisenstein Gymnasium in Copenhagen, Denmark. When I first told my students in New York and in Chicago that we were starting this partnership, the first question I got was, "That's nice. What's Denmark?" That's part of the idea of Project Rousseau, exposing you to new things. And the great thing about it, what makes me so proud, even more than the fact that my kids can now handle this exchange program, is that we've started a student committee of students who guide the exchange program, so that it's really what they want to do. We also have programs like what we have with Reisenstein at Amaf School in Nairobi, Kenya, and schools in Haiti and China. You'll have opportunities to be pen pals, to participate on blogs, and make videos for a student of yours who you would be partnered with at any of these schools. If this sounds interesting to you and you want to learn more, all you have to do is ask your mentor. That's the way that we communicate in Project Rousseau. It's the students to the mentors and then up from there. That way we really make sure that we're doing exactly what you want. As much as Project Rousseau works on academics and test scores, we're not all about academics. Because we know that some of the best learning you'll ever do will happen outside of the classroom. I can show you all sorts of diagrams on what a black hole is, but it's very different to go to a planetarium, see a space show, and then talk with an expert afterwards. These are the sorts of things we do outside of the classroom as a group with our students and as our mentors. It's an experience that we all share together. We just recently went to a planetarium show and had an astronomer talk to us afterwards about what we had seen. In fact, three of those kids who were on those trips now want to be an astronomer. You'll find that you have interests that you didn't even know about. So for those of you who say, well, college really doesn't excite me because I haven't found anything in school that excites me, that's okay. We can work on that together. What you'll soon realize, and what your mentor will help you realize, is that there is not a single career out there that is not made easier by having a college degree. And as you talk to your mentor about career exploration, you'll see all of these different opportunities that are afforded to you when you work harder. Joe, one of our college counselors here in the Northeast, has a line that I love to share with my students. You get as much out of your school experience as you put into it. So when you say something like, I haven't found anything that interests me in school, part of that is that you haven't explored. So we'll help you explore. If you're interested in learning a new language, we can do that. If you're interested in learning about building cars, like you heard with Denzel, we can do that. We have all these different options, and we add things constantly because our goal is to do exactly what you want and help you explore your exact careers. Once you find something, or maybe a number of somethings, that you find really interesting, and I guarantee you it exists, something that interests you, we then work back to the academics. And what you'll find is you'll become a much better student than you ever were, because you'll have motivation that you didn't have before. You'll say to yourself, I really want to be a pilot, or I really want to be a doctor, or I really want to do whatever it may be. And in order to get there, I need better grades, higher test scores, and all the different things that need to be done. It's not like they're different elements of Project Rousseau. It's just that it's different faces of the same coin. Because everything wraps itself up into one clean package that is the student who walks across the stage on graduation.
Going to the shelter, it's sort of like a break from your everyday life. Like, instead of being all, you know, me, let me focus on grades, going to the shelter, it feels good to know that, you know, you're helping someone and you're doing something. And I think that whole, like, giving back to the community, it sort of helps with, like, the whole you reap what you sow, and being able to help people, that's a really good feeling.
One of my personal favorite parts of Project Rousseau is our community service initiatives. After all, Project Rousseau is an organization run by volunteers. And if there's anything that makes me feel like I've really done my job with a student, it's when Alejandro came up to me after he filmed for this very video and said, I really want to be a mentor for Project Rousseau when I'm in college. I can do that, right? And I said, absolutely. There's no one better than you to share something with a student about the path that one needs to take to get to college and succeed there. We work constantly to instill the values of community service in our students. And after a very short while, it's not work anymore. It comes naturally to all of us. For the last 2.5 years, Project Rousseau students in New York City and in Newark, New Jersey, have convened every Sunday to serve food to the homeless. We spend hours together, and after a while you forget that you're even cooking. I'm not very good at cooking. We go there because we're a family, and it really feels that way. And nothing makes me feel like more of a proud father than when I see my students working together as a team to serve a community that's really in need. Here at McGavock, Grant and I are already working on planning community service events for you. You'll have a Habitat for Humanity build. There's a soup kitchen that we're working on a partnership with, so you can do exactly what my students do up north, and tons of other things. And the great thing about this is that you're gonna meet Project Rousseau students from other schools when you go on these community service trips. The Habitat for Humanity build will be done jointly with our students in Memphis. And you'll find that we'll build a real family and a real great support net of friends of yours who are going through exactly the same thing as you are. SAT prep doesn't feel quite as bad when you know that there are a few hundred other kids in Project Rousseau who are going through exactly the same thing. And what's great to see is that we have study groups that have formed over Facebook of students of ours who are doing SAT prep in Haiti and those doing it in the United States and different places in the United States, and all work together towards the same goal. That's all built through community service, because community service to me means helping anyone in need. It's not just serving the homeless in the kitchen, although that's a lot of what we do. It's about developing this sense that you have not just the responsibility, but more importantly, the capability to make a difference in someone else's life. And when you do community service with Project Rousseau, you'll feel empowered to know, wow, I really did make a difference. We share the thank you letters and all of those things that we get from our community service programs because I want you to see how much of a difference you can make. And if you can make a difference now, imagine how much of a difference you'll make 6 or 7 years from now, 8 years from now, 10 years from now, when you have a college degree. And when you have skills that you don't have at this current point. When I was in high school, I was very frustrated because I already knew I wanted to be a teacher, but I was too young and I couldn't do anything about it. And I couldn't help the people who I wanted to help most. Now I'm able to do that, and in 5 years I'll be able to do it even better. But I would never have started on this path if I hadn't started with community service when I was your age. It's not just helping, it's also a lot of fun. We've made pies on Thanksgiving. We make gingerbread cookies for the holidays. And we have other special events that we do through our community service to make it as fun and as group, as much of a group project and as enjoyable for everyone involved as possible.
Nice experience. You get to make it, you serve it, you get to talk with them, see what they see, how they are, what they've been through, what they're doing now. It's a rewarding experience. It's a nice thing to do, and you just feel good inside just for doing that.
It's so fun. I mean, we cook, and it's like, it's not like work. I don't think of it as work. I think like it's fun. I get to spend time. Mm-hmm. And not only like having fun, but I'm also helping other people, so that's so much better.
I remember when we did pie day. That was really fun.
Yeah, we had to, like,
so many
the
pies,
boxes. Everywhere. Oh my God. I came home and I bought like 3 pies, I think. And my mom was like, what are you going to eat this? Like, what are you going to give this to? Because like, they were big too.
Yeah.
They were like this big. It was really yummy.
Now you might ask yourself, what do Project Rousseau students do for fun? I always say that SAT prep is plenty of fun, but my students don't quite agree. We have tons of fun things we do. We go to a lot of games. We get tickets all the time to games. You'll be going to Vanderbilt football games in the fall and Vanderbilt basketball games in the winter, and to professional games as well. We have movie nights where you select the movie and we'll bring the food. And then we have something really fun called Days on Campus, where every single Project Rousseau student in the country will be going to his mentor's or her mentor's campus on the same day, and you'll spend the day on campus or the afternoon on campus. We all then join each other for dinner in one of the dining halls. And let me tell you, for all of you who complain about the food at your cafeteria, college cafeterias are a whole lot better.
McGavock High School, welcome to Project Rousseau.
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 McGavock High School, welcome to Project Rousseau.